We have been talking about design guidelines for individual classes. This time we will revisit the guidelines of an overall system design. At runtime, the system becomes a group of objects interacting with each other. This interaction is a result of already working system. However, system specification takes its origin from an early stage of design, known as requirements gathering. It is written down in a form of the requirements summary document. Early on, we begin to differentiate between properties of relevant entities in our problem domain context. Modularity of design leads to components that interact with other components. Components interact through properly documented interface. When components are identified, they uncover similarities between objects. Discovery of analogous ideas creates foundation for abstraction mechanisms. Designers must embrace every opportunity to abstract similar features into common parts of system. Similarities of structure, operations, and behavior can be classified and organized into hierarchical relationships. Lack of abstraction makes the opposite. It wreaks chaos, creates software bugs, and imposes light forms of insanity. Abstraction represents a view of object classification consistent with requirements of our problem. Inside our application, encapsulation conceals characteristics of individual objects. From outside, objects can be viewed through specification of the interface. From the inside, the view is internal implementation. Encapsulation enforces a clear separation of those two views. Encapsulation realizes the policies of a good object-oriented design. Each class of objects becomes responsible for its state and behavior while interacting with object-oriented environment. State of the object is defined by the current values of its attributes. Each class defines a fixed set of properties. Object can change its state by changing property values. Defined by changes of state, object sends messages to other objects in response to incoming messages. Objects perform various operations in response to received messages. Objects can require operations from other objects by sending messages to them. A class of objects represents the common structure and behavior of a group of objects. Classes implement new data types, otherwise unknown to the environment. Objects are instances of particular classes. Objects obtain their attributes and operations from classes. object-oriented software is a collection of classes, connected by relationships. Good software systems have well-designed internal structure, also known as system architecture. Problem domain contains real-world objects. Proper design provides clear mapping between objects and problem domain. Good design helps to reuse existing system components and components provided by the libraries. For example, inheritance significantly reduces repetition of the same code. It is against good design rules to imagine the software model and its implementation only as a family of interacting functions. For this to be operational, functions must share centralized state, since local variables do not survive beyond individual function calls. Centralized state is defined as global. Individual functions represent procedural approach to carrying necessary tasks. Functions can encapsulate only the algorithms. Such functions themselves are global, because every operation is accessible from anywhere. Global functions are also known as free functions, or procedures. Procedural system is based on global state. The global state is not encapsulated. All of this must be avoided in a good object-oriented design. Primary reason for this is to avoid potential side effects. Side effects are caused by global functions as a result of changes in the global state. Even one single isolated global variable must be considered as a very serious design flaw. Encapsulation provides balance between interface and implementation. During project design stage, encapsulation usually means keeping the interfaces small. During programming stage, encapsulation means scope management. This includes keeping the scopes as small as possible. This also includes limited visibility of variables as much as possible. Model, design, and implementation consists of objects which begin to interact at runtime. Objects are autonomous and have their own state and behavior. In summary, objects encapsulate state kept by the attribute variables. Objects expose useful behavior in form of algorithms, methods, and operations. Thank you.